Good morning. Happy Wednesday. I hope everybody is doing well. If you don't know me, I'm Nicole from Shift, and I wanted to do my part and bring some friends and practitioners and healers on to share their gifts. And this morning, I'm really excited. One of the most beautiful souls I know, Kelly Gores, is coming on, and not only does she inspire me daily and constantly, but she's been just a pillar of support for me in my entire journey with Shift. And I'm excited to bring Kelly on.
Hi, beauty.
Hi.
What's been going on? How are you? Tell me how you've been spending your days.
I'm really taking advantage of slowing down. I didn't ask for it in this form, but but it's been nice to, you know, remove some non-essential distraction and really have time to do a lot of inner work and creative work and spend quality time with my little baby.
It's been really such a privilege to watch your journey unfold. If anybody doesn't know, Kelly did one of the most remarkable documentaries ever, Heal, and also the book. It was so good. You know, something that I think we're so fortunate in is I think we've had a head start in our journeys of this that I think has kind of prepared us for a time like this. But I have some questions. I have a lot of questions. And I want to dig in. Can we talk about routine and a daily toolkit? Because I know that's really important to me. And I know you have a solid one.
I think daily practices are essential because we live in a time where, I mean, obviously this time right now with COVID is highly intense and emotional and challenging. Yeah. And as Greg Braden says in the Q&A that I did on Sunday, you know, we are built for times like this. We are resilient and we're, you know, evolutionary. We adapt. So daily practices, one of my foundations, I learned how to meditate in 2007. It has completely changed my life. Meditation to me is just a very practical tool every day. Do what you can. If you don't have time to meditate, they say sit for an hour.
That's a lot.
It's like a zen. So meditation, you know, lowers stress. It lowers inflammation. They've tested this with Joe Dispenza's workshops and many other studies. 4 to 5 days of meditation boost your immune function by 50 to 100%. I look at it as necessary as physical and personal hygiene. You know, we shower the gunk that builds up on our skin. And it's the same with your mind, the mental
stress. It's kind of like a mental cleanse.
Yeah. You've got a mental, it's a mental shower, you know. The next is connecting with nature. You know, we live in a very high-tech world. We're inundated in our homes and our offices with invisible EMFs and Wi-Fi and blah, 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 blah that we don't really know the effects of. So disconnecting from tech and connecting with the earth, whether it's going for a hike, just sitting in the sunshine for 20 minutes, putting your feet in the earth for 20 minutes, all of those things have like profound healing effects. So that's part of my daily practice.
Just talking to somebody about doing kind of visualization and visualization in your meditation of nature so that if you can't get out, if you can't put your feet on the grass, if you can't go sit in the sunshine, at least in your mind, kind of close your eyes and go through. One day last week that I noticed I was a little like just agitated through the day. And I was taking a bath in the evening and I realized, I was, oh my God, I was so busy in the morning, I didn't meditate. And it kind of made me realize, wow, I've been in a pretty solid practice. Mm-hmm. It was so cool to see. There was validation to know, oh, there's a reason I'm doing this. And it actually, now I have my own validation.
It's just a total reset. It's like the reset button. We got meditation, we got connection with nature, and then movement, exercise. I grew up an athlete. Movement for me is equal parts physical and mental. It's mm-hmm. therapy. So I call it movement therapy every day. Yeah. And emotion is energy and emotion. And a lot of times when we repress or suppress or we don't express, it gets stuck in our tissues. And to move the lymph system and sweat it out. And then I like to do gratitude work, which, you know, I think humans have a default, especially in the Western world, to complain. So gratitude practice is a way to take your attention off what you don't like happening, which we often complain about, but we need to pivot our attention, whatever it is. There's so many things to be grateful about. My lungs are working. My heart is beating.
Our air hasn't been this clean. And however long, you know, the dolphins in the canals.
There's no traffic. There's no traffic on the 405. It's amazing.
Right. How do we start to process and let go of what was to make room? for yeah. what could be.
Yeah, I mean,
that's a this is serious
the,
thought.
The spiritual conversation around this whole situation. You know, I remember the first 2 weeks of, you know, shelter in place. Everybody was in such a high state of panic and fear. It was just like contagious. It was far more viral than the actual virus, I believe. The right. fear and the panic. And then, you know, you go through these cycles, then you kind of settle into a rhythm. Then that, you know, that initial fear kind of wears off. And there's still uncertainty with the virus in the future. But now we're in kind of a rhythm, you know, life is going to be different after this. We're being forced to look at things, which is beautiful. But, you know, we don't grow in comfort. We grow in challenging times, and we are meant, our souls are meant to grow and evolve and learn and wake up. And so this is just another, you know, kind of alchemical opportunity.
I mean, I'm doing the best that I can to take this time to go within and connect to myself and love and light and grow. And I would hope that anybody sees this, you know, as the opportunity to grow and kind of reemerge.
You're doing amazing. Really good... Yeah, you're looking
thank you.
Good shift, mind, thank body, you. Soul. This is like a perfect time to shift.
Well, thank you. And, you know, so it's like, I have that example for myself that once my focus changed, you know, my life was in a big transition when we met, and I went from taking care of somebody, thinking I was taking care of myself, to how do I take care of myself? And then I changed my focus on what I was doing. And there's no coincidence that since creating Shift, knock on something, my lupus has been as in check as it's ever been since I was diagnosed. And I hope that this is a lesson for so many.
If there's a vision that you want to create and bring forth to the world, this is the time to start writing a business plan or writing about it or connecting with people.
Yeah, nurture it.
This is another opportunity to see where we aren't aligned with our true vision and calling and explore mm-hmm. that, you know.
The best way we're all going to really come out of this is through generosity. You know, these people who are on the front lines and who are going through trauma and who are going to need healing, and the world is going to need so much healing, and child abuse is on the rise and all of that. So I think, what can I do? You know, I'm so blessed and lucky. How do I do something that can be of service?
That quote, you know, it is in giving that we receive. It's mm-hmm. so true. We are meant to be of service.
Absolutely. But I want to talk about Joe Dispenza for a second. So I'm fascinated by him. And I really, really, really want to go to one of his programs. Joe explained in the film how he healed himself. And will you explain the quantum field a bit?
Yeah. So Joe Dispenza was a chiropractor when he was in his early 20s, and he was doing a triathlon. A car came out of nowhere and hit him off his bike, broke like, I don't know, 6-7 vertebrae. His doctors told him he'd probably never walk again. And so he went home and he couldn't do anything. He couldn't move, really. So he just had his mind to use. He just really had this voice come through that said, you know, the power that made the body heals the body. So he started to visualize his spine healing. And then his mind would go sideways and start to think of fear thoughts of being in a wheelchair and not ever running again. And then he started visualizing, like, what did he miss doing that he loved doing before? So he started feeling those feelings of gratitude and joy that came with those things that he missed. And so he started noticing that when he did those things, his body started feeling better. The tingling went away. He combined visualization with elevated emotions. And in 10 weeks, his whole spine had healed. And in 12 weeks, he was back out training for another triathlon. And
so cool.
Yeah. Essentially, his whole thing is about we're all connected by this invisible field called the quantum field. And he says, you know, in the field, there's infinite possibilities.
Yeah. And it's so interesting. Anybody that does work like that, it's so powerful. Mm-hmm. Some could see the glass half full and some could see the glass half empty. This virus is invisible. Yet it sort of brought us to our knees. Mm-hmm. So how do we empower ourselves as opposed to being a victim to it?
You know, 99.9% of us are looking outside of ourselves to, you know, we're looking to the external to have an inner experience. We want people and circumstances to be a certain way. And when they are, then we'll be happy. Now we're in this very kind of uncertain time. And so we're learning to do the inner work so we can generate our own feelings of peace and calm, regardless of what's going on in the external. You know, we are one human family and know that we all deserve love and connection.